How are you supposed to properly design a huge network of pipes? I mean, there can literally be billions of combinations, and there's no way you, as a time-deficient engineer, have time to run through them all. So like most people, you probably resort to heuristics or rules of thumb, project experience or manager experience. Well, we suggest you ditch those archaic ways of sizing and you step into the 21st century using numerical methods to find the best network size. And that's exactly what our brand new product, Automated Network Sizing, does for you. And it's an add-on module for the base AFT and AFT Aero programs. With it, you're going to avoid deadline-driven compromise, edge out your competition, and design intelligently. And yes, excellent question, it is 50% off, but only through December, so you gotta act quickly. But let me give you a quick demo of exactly why you need this product. So here we've got a pretty simple cooling loop system, right? Well, according to the demand I need through the heat exchangers and two heuristics, this ought to be a 14-inch pipe. So that is P10, I want you to pay attention to that, okay? Great, well let's see what our brand new friend Automated Network Sizing has to say about that. So here we go to the sizing tab, right? Okay, my objective is to minimize pipe weight. Great. Well, what pipes do I want to size, and are there what we call common size groups? Of course, intuitively you know that in and out of a heat exchanger should be the same size pipe, or maybe the suction and discharge side of the pump. So let's see, oh, there we go, we've got the common size group set up. However, I don't know what size that should be. So I have a really large candidate set ranging from 1 inch all the way to 36 inches. And that's going to be steel pipe, I've chosen that. You can specify all of this. And of course, this has to be tied down by design requirements. Again, user specified, unique to your system. So for this system, we need a maximum velocity of 12. So everything's gotta be below 12 feet per second. Okay, got a minimum pressure, great. In the pump, I have a minimum net positive suction head margin because I want to avoid cavitation in my pump. In the control valve, I've got a minimum pressure drop that we're trying to control, great. Okay, so with that, that's going to drive our design. Last step, simple as that, we want to choose our sizing method. And here I have chosen discrete sizing because I only want to size for commercially available sizes, which makes sense, probably what you would want to do too. Here we go, run the model. That's it, in a matter of seconds, we've run through hundreds of designs and come up with the best one that meets all of our design requirements for the pipe, pump, control valve, all of that. And look at that, P10, what I told you to look at before, said it was supposed to be a 14-inch pipe. Here, using the sizing tool, we have a 10-inch pipe. And this is my favorite part, because we've been able to reduce all of that. It used to weigh 190,000 pounds. Now it weighs 176,000 pounds. That's a weight savings of 14,000 pounds, which translates directly into money. And exactly, that's why you need this product. So if you give us a shout here at the phone number 719-686-1000 or email below info@aft.com, we will be glad to walk you through this product and to answer any questions you have. Thank you and best of luck in your engineering endeavors.